Hello YouTube, and I welcome all of you back to another rage video where today, ladies and gentlemen, or tonight I should say, we have got a very, very, very special number on us today. It's Rush's debut album. Now, for those you may recognize Rush's like debut album cover, it's just Rush set against what's I think it's sort of like an explosion of light. Which, I never found out. Apparently, that is literally just called Finding My Way, which I think is a pretty interesting sort of name for a title, for an album, I suppose. Correct me if I'm wrong. And also, remember, what you have to remember is that 1974, a 47-year-old album. There's not many. I know quite a lot of people in my own family, ladies and gentlemen. Not even that. A lot of them are a lot older than that, which it's kind of amazing when you think about it. But I'll tell you what is also fascinating, well, amazing about this is that this is pre Neil Peart, God rest his soul, acts for Rush, because this has John Rutsey, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, as their drummer, and I'm looking forward to this. I mean, I know, fine, well, all you're going to say is that Rutsey is no Neil Peart. But then again, you know, Clive Burr was no Nico McBrain or Neil Peart or even a Ringo Starr for that matter. With that being said and done, I'm going to get into like a lot of my feelings about this afterwards. But this is the last time I made a video about Rush. Must have been something coming up to 11 months ago. And I think it was like Show Don't Tell. I think that was the last song I did. So this is like, we're going all the way back to the beginning. We are going to find our way once more. So if you guys want to check out the original video for yourselves, links will all be in the description down below. You know what? I can't do this. I've got to do this properly. So you know what? Take this ugly as hell jacket up, shirt off. Come on, where is it? Oh, here it is. I'm not even gonna like wear like shades for this one because I feel like this one piece of garment that, you know, that Rush demands it. Lovely. And it's not even often that I do, you know, music reactions without my shades or my jacket. That just, I think kind of like Rush demands it. So, Finding My Way in 3, 2, 1, and... Ladies and gentlemen, is this Rush? This sounds like Led Zeppelin. Like, what the hell's going on? This isn't Rush. I know I could obviously hear, you know, Geddy getting himself started. I know I can tell that's Geddy from a mile away, but I mean, God, how old would have Geddy and Alex would have been? They would have been in their mid-20s, they probably would have been my age when this came about. What the hell?
Well, I sang some sad songs.
Was that really like their first, bro? Like literally, if this really was my introduction to Rush, in fact, you know what? Let's say for all intents and purposes, this was my introduction to Rush. You know what I'm thinking to myself, ladies and gentlemen? This really, it's sort of like, it's strange because Finding My Way has. Here's a good comparison. How many of you guys, honest to God, have ever seen the very first episode of Pokemon? Tell me right now. Anyone who recalls Ash meeting Pikachu for the first time, they don't get along very well. Pikachu is very hesitant. He is very reluctant to obey Ash at any turn whatsoever. Ash is so clearly inexperienced because his head is full of stardust about becoming a Pokemon master, and they eventually begin their adventure together, resulting in the Ho-Ho creepypasta. At least I think it's what they call a creepypasta anyway, so it's got that going for it. You don't know why I mentioned that in particular. It's because when you think about it, imagine Finding My Way is like the first episode to a TV show. It's got to stand out amongst the pack. It's got to establish who's who. It's got to establish several themes. It's got to establish what the goal ultimately is. It's got to establish characters. It's got to establish a world, a setting, and then it can move on to the next parts. Finding My Way, without wanting to put too fine a point on it, this would come a lot of stuff you could find in Finding My Way. This wonderful enthusiasm to go out on adventure to, like they say, finding my way. It's about finding your place in the world. And why better not go out there with literally the wind in your hair, and you know, it's going out on an adventure. That's what, for me, Finding My Way is all about. It's about the hero's journey, the beginning of an adventure. And Rush, for those who know, and I know myself, would say that Rush have had a very, very storied history. And they have like I said, those that know will absolutely testify that Rush is the best thing to ever come out of Canada. Like, literally ever. So, with that being said, something I kind of like wanted to move on to right now is something I never technically... I mean, I know that Rush did get some, like, level of criticism because, well, not a lot of people really, like, got their style, I suppose. But that's probably in part to what I saw right here. As the opening track of the debut album for a newcomer band, yeah, like I was saying, Finding My Way had to work hard in a time where such bands as Led Zeppelin, The Who, Black Sabbath, and Deep Purple had control over the genre of hard rock. The opening shout that kicks off the album, however, definitely cemented Rush in the annals of rock history. The track's production was more advanced than most others on the album, and had to be recorded in a separate location from the majority of other tracks on the record. That's quite interesting, to be honest, because there's a lot of things about, well, the Rush's debut album that I'm not technically super aware of. The only thing I do know from very faint memory is the song Working Man. Now, I've got a lot to say about Working Man by the time we get to it, but just before we end, I kind of like a few things I kind of like wanted to say. First off, how did I get introduced to Rush in the first place? Let's see, it was about 2 years ago, back in February, I did the song called 2112. Unfortunately, I didn't realize it was the whole album, and I was utterly captivated by it. Its production and everything else involved. And then the next question I kind of like want to ask is, and maybe this is something I'll find out in a few videos' time, is how did Neil Peart actually get involved in Rush in the first place? Because literally, I think John Rutsey was only on this album, and Neil Peart, without wanting to put too fine a point on it, kind of took over. And then it was the wind in Rush's sails. Well, he was quite a lot of other things besides, but when we get to when Neil Peart basically took over, we will get to it. But John Rutsey, I'll never with you. I liked his style. I mean, I could definitely pinpoint moments where he definitely kind of like went, oh, okay, and I hope to God, I'm going to do that right now. I'm going to find out whether or not John Rutsey was in anything else. Canadian musician. Years active. Oh. Years active, 1963 to 1974. So this was his last work. Oh boy. And he died in 2008 at the age of 55. I'll get to probably talking a bit more about Rutsey later on, because I feel like it would be fitting to anyway, but I hope you guys have enjoyed this reaction video to Finding My Way. Please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section down below. Let me know what you guys thought of the song for yourselves, and I will hope to see all of you guys again in the next video. Take care, bye-bye for now.